Gentlemen of the press, I, Alhaji Mujahid Dokubo Asari, Alawedi Abala of Kalawari, want to say that I stand by the statement I made, and I want to go on further to make the following. If any more attacks are carried out that affects our people, or we perceive that attacks are going to be carried out, we'll carry out preemptive action and disproportionate reaction to any attack that is being planned, that is going to be carried out. It's quite unfortunate that the oligarchy in the north, represented by the feudal Fulanis, who migrated and invaded our land from Futajelon, and continue to show disregard and disrespect for the owners of the country they came into. And people have tolerated them for a very long time, but that will no longer continue. I want to refresh your memory that on the 5th of October 2010, a Fulani, Lawal Keita, former governor of Old Kaduna State, said this: anything short of a northern president is tantamount to stealing our presidency. Johnathan has to go, and he will go. Emphasis. Even if he uses the incumbency power to get his nomination on the platform of the PDP, he will be frustrated out. Emphasis. He will be frustrated out. The North is determined, if that happened, to make the country ungovernable for President Goodluck Johnathan or any other Southerner who finds his way to the seat of power on the platform of the People's Democratic Party against the principles of the party zoning policy. Today, insurgent group, in furtherance to this clarion call from the feudal Fulani occupiers of our land, had wreaked havoc. They're attacking barracks and seizing weapons. Their foot soldiers in the army are planning a coup, because at the top they cannot plan a coup. And Goodluck Johnathan is just sitting and watching. But we will not sit and watch. For every action, there will be an equal and opposite reaction, and it will be disproportionate. And nobody arrested this fellow, this invader from Futajelon, Lawan Keita. Nobody arrested him. He's walking free. After that, another Fulani who had used our money to overthrow democratically elected government, a corrupt Fulani, General Muhammad Buhari, very corrupt, highly corrupt, rotten, made this statement. God willing, by 2015, he made this statement, May 15th, 2012. God willing, by 2015, something will happen. God willing, by 2015, something will happen. Emphasis. They either conduct a free and fair election or they go a disgraceful way. If what happened in 2011 should again happen in 2015, by the grace of God, the dog and the baboon would all be soaked in blood. He was never arrested. This man, in all civilized countries, in Chile, General Pinochet, is being tried. There is a call for his extradition. Former military leaders are being tried in Pakistan. It is only in this clan here that these things are not happening. That a man who overthrew a legitimate government continued to threaten us with blood and nothing has happened? Who is this criminal who took our guns, our resources to plan and overthrow a legitimate government without any reason whatsoever? And introduce laws, retroactive laws, that led to the death of citizens. Nothing has happened. To cram it all, another Fulani invader of our homeland continued. Let me also use this opportunity to say on the behalf of us, one Farouk Adamu Aliyu, us in the north, that nobody has the monopoly of violence. We have not had Maitaisini in the south. We have not had Boko Haram in the south. We have not had Shia revolt in the south. But this man is telling us that let us also use this opportunity to say on behalf of us in the north that nobody has the monopoly of violence. We thank God that they don't have, because we are going to give them surplus violence. That on behalf of the people of Northern Extraction, there shall be no one Nigeria if a Northerner is not elected president. No Northerner will ever, ever be elected president in this country again. There will be no one Nigeria if a Northerner is not elected president. Because the politics is a game of number they don't have. There is nowhere. And arid land is more populated than the fertile south or the savannah. If it is so, Mali should have been more populated than Nigeria. Niger should have been more populated than Nigeria. Chad should have been more populated than Nigeria. Burkina Faso should have been more populated than Nigeria. They are all our neighbors. How come it is only this belt of Fulani marauders that are more populated than us? We will not allow it. We will not continue. We know that we are more populated than them, and no figure they will bring will be accepted. He said, the game of number and the job people are not up to 1 million or 2 million or even 5 million. Let us tell them we are ready for them. I am not afraid of arrest. I've been arrested before. I was put under SSS underground 10 months, 11 days. I was buried alive. And I came out alive. I did not give up. I did not capitulate. I was detained for 22 months, 10 days. I did not capitulate. So I am not afraid of arrest. But they will never arrest me. Because if they do, the consequences of my arrest, Nigeria would be history. I am saying it bold and clear without missing word that the consequences of my arrest, Nigeria will be history. The last time my arrest reduced Nigerian oil production to 700,000 barrels. This time it will be zero. And we will match violence by violence. We will match intrigues by intrigues. We will match bullet by bullet. We will match blood by blood. We are ready for them. Goodluck Johnathan will complete his tenure of 2 terms, whether they like it or not. To us, they don't even exist. Because we pay them. He who pays the piper dictates the tunes. We pay them. We feed them. They are parasites. They are a burden on us. They have no reason to be with us. They have no reason whatsoever to be with us. And this is not the first time we have expressed, the people, the aborigine of this country, of this land, have expressed this opinion. Gideon Oka expressed it, and all our people have it in their mind that these invaders must be expelled from our land. And we will follow it to the letter. And we are daring them to arrest me. I am daring them to arrest me if they can. If they don't, they are cowards, and shame on them. There will be no peace for the man who does not want peace. When we were in the creek, we fought for a just cause. We never fought and killed innocent people. They continue to kill, and people tell us, leave them alone. No duo, if you do. You know them now. That time is gone forever and ever. And we are saying that it is in their best interest to behave. It is in their best interest to behave, because they had no value, they are destitute, they are parasites, They contribute nothing. We feed them and we condone their excesses, but we will no longer condone their excesses. Thank you very much. If there is any question.